students, last week we studied about kinetic energy, gravitational potential energy and elastic potential energy, and we also derived the expression. Who will tell me the formula of kinetic energy? Yes, what is the formula of kinetic energy? Yes, Jia.
Half mv square.
Yes, half mv square. Who will tell me the formula of gravitational potential energy now? Yes, gravitational potential energy. Only one student raised hand. What about others? Yes, Divya.
MGH.
MGH, yes. Gravitational potential energy is MGH. Who will tell me the formula for elastic potential energy now? What is elastic potential energy? Yes, students, elastic potential energy. I told you about Hooke's law and elastic potential energy. Yes, Jia.
Minus kx.
F is equal to minus kx, that is Hooke's law. And using that, we get elastic potential energy. What is that? Yes, Soumya raised hand. Yes, Soumya.
Ma'am, potential energy is equal to half kx square.
Yes, half kx square. That is elastic potential energy. So these things we did last week, right? Now I'm going to share a simulator. We were doing transformation of energy. Conversion of one form of energy into the other, you know, that is called transformation of energy. So we saw how an electric fan converts electrical energy to mechanical energy, how an electric bulb converts electrical energy to light and heat energy, and so on, right? So based on the conversion of energy, I'm going to share a simulator with you for better understanding. See that. Is it visible? Is it visible, students? And why is the strength so thin today? Okay, they are still joining. Okay, fine. So see, when the child starts cycling, okay, have a look at the turbine of generator, it starts rotating. And then you have a look at the mercury in the barometer, mercury in the thermometer. Okay, let us see whether it rises or not. Okay, fine. Let us have a look at mercury in the barometer. Then we will see whether it rises or not. It has started rising, you see. And if I increase the speed of cycling, you will see water gets heated up. Water in this electric container gets heated up and temperature is still rising. You see, now it has crossed the 3 divisions. It is rising and rising, and see, now the steam is coming out of water. So what is happening actually? What kind of energy conversion is taking place here? Who will tell me? Tell me the sequence of energy conversions taking place here. Yes. Who will tell me the sequence of energy transformations taking place here? Anyone? Yes, raise hand if you know. Very simple. Yes, Prachi. Okay, Prachi, you explain.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it is the conversion from mechanical energy to heat energy.
And then, not directly from mechanical to heat energy. First of all, yes, who else can tell? Before I tell, is there anyone who can tell about this? Yes. Yes, raise hand if you know. Yes, Gia, raise hand. Do you want to tell? It's very simple. You can easily make out. We have done all the types of energies. So you can easily tell which energy is converted into which form and further. Yes? Anyone? Okay, I tell you the first one. So first of all, muscular energy of child is being utilized. Okay, muscular energy of child. Yes, Jatin.
Ma'am, muscular energy is converted into electrical energy, then it is converted into heat energy.
Muscular energy is converted into?
Ma'am, electrical.
First of all, see, muscular energy is running the turbine. Turbine starts rotating. So muscular energy is first converted into kinetic energy of turbine. Then generator. Electrical energy will be produced by generator. And then heat energy of water. Then it is ultimately converted into heat energy of water. So sequence of energy transformations is taking place. Okay, now I am replacing the source with sun. And this with solar cell panel. And this thing with a bulb. Who can explain the sequence of energy transformations taking place here? This is actually a solar power plant where electricity is generated using solar energy. Yes? Who can tell me the sequence of energy transformations taking place here? Yes, Titiksha?
Ma'am, light energy to electrical energy.
And then to?
Light energy. And light heat energy. Heat
energy, both. So see, first of all, solar energy. Solar energy of sun, that is falling on solar cell panel. Solar cell panel converts that solar energy into electrical energy. With the help of that electrical energy, this bulb is producing heat and light energy. So the sequence of energy transformations taking place here is solar energy to electrical energy to heat and light. So this is the sequence of steps. Same way, I can replace the source by cooker also, and the steam of cooker will fall on generator, and let us see whether this bulb glows or not. So I have turned the burner on. See, with the help of that heat, with the help of steam coming out of nozzle of pressure cooker, the turbine of generator starts rotating and this electric bulb starts glowing. Again, if I replace it by this water system, temperature will start rising. See, at the level of mercury in the thermometer, it is rising and rising. And water is getting heated up and see, steam has started coming out. So again, some energy transformation is taking place here. So it is not that always one form of energy is converted into one form. It may be converted into other forms, or there may be a sequence of energy transformations taking place. I hope so. This concept must be clear to you. And that day we did thermal power plant also. So who will tell me what is the sequence of energy transformations taking place at a thermal power plant? Yes. Who else? Anyone else? Thermal power plant. Thermal means heat. Yes, anyone else? Jatin has also answered. Prachi has also answered. Titiksha has also already answered. Who else? Yes? Anyone else who has not yet answered? Any question? Dharia, would you like to? Dharia, would you like to explain? Thermal power plant, where coal is burned to produce steam and then steam is used to run the generator. So now I have given you the hint.
Ma'am, chemical energy.
First of all, chemical energy of coal. Yes. Coal is used to boil water. So what happens? Chemical energy of coal is converted into? Into what?
Heat
energy of water. heat energy of boiling water, and then that is converted into kinetic energy of steam. Steam nikalni start ho jayegi. That steam will run the turbine. So what will be there? Kinetic energy of turbine, and then it will run the generator, then electrical energy by generator. So this is the sequence of energy transformations taking place here. So I'm writing on the board again. Thermal power plant. Okay, thermal power plant. So let us write the sequence of energy transformations taking place at a thermal power plant. Okay, so first of all, chemical energy of coal is converted into heat energy of water, heat energy of steam. So I am writing directly into heat energy of steam, into mechanical energy or kinetic energy of turbines. You can write kinetic energy also, and then electrical energy by generator. Electrical energy will be produced by the generator. So this is the sequence of energy transformations taking place at a thermal power plant. Okay, so this is a good example of transformation of energy. All right. After this, next is hydroelectric power plant. Hydro means water, means I'm talking about a dam. So how electrical energy is produced at a dam? Let us write that sequence of energy transformations if you have noted here. So next is hydroelectric power plant. A hydroelectric power plant. Hydroelectric power plant. So how it happens, you know, water is stored in dams at a height. So first of all, water is stored in dams at a height. What kind of energy is possessed by water? Who will tell me? What kind of energy is possessed by water stored in dams? Yes. Aryan.
Gravitational potential energy.
Yes, gravitational potential energy. Then this water is allowed to fall on turbines kept at ground level. So first of all, there was gravitational potential energy. The water is allowed to fall on turbines kept at ground level with a large pressure. What will happen? What energy will the turbines have? Yes. Which energy will be possessed by the turbines now? Yes, students, raise hand. Same students are raising hand again and again. What about others? Yes, what will happen? Turbines will start rotating. So which energy will the turbines possess? Which energy will the turbines possess now? Yes, Jatin.
Ma'am, kinetic energy, then it will convert into electrical energy.
Yes. So first of all, we are talking about turbines. So kinetic energy of rotating turbines. Gravitational potential energy will be converted into the kinetic energy of rotating turbines. Then these rotating turbines, they will turn the shaft of generator. They will rotate the coil of generator, which is kept between two pole pieces of magnet. This is a generator. So what kind of energy will be produced by generator? You know, electrical energy. Electrical energy will be produced by the generator. So what is the sequence of energy transformation? gravitational potential energy of water stored in dams, to kinetic energy of rotating turbines, to electrical energy produced by generator. So this is the sequence of energy transformations taking place at a hydroelectric power plant. Is that clear? So after that, our next topic is conservation of energy, the law of conservation of energy. Next is the law of conservation of energy. So give this heading. If you look at any system, okay, if you look at any system, total energy of any system in this universe always remains constant. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be converted from one form into the other. हम ना एनर्जी को जनरेट कर सकते हैं, हम ये कह रहे हैं ना, जो जनरेटर इज प्रोड्यूसिंग इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी, इट इज ऑल्सो नॉट प्रोड्यूसिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, इट इज कन्वर्टिंग वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी इनटू द अदर, इट इज कन्वर्टिंग दिस मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इनटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. ओके, जनरेटर कांट जनरेट एनर्जी, इट इज जस्ट कन्वर्टिंग वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी इनटू द अदर. सो एनर्जी कैन नीदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉर बी डिस्ट्रॉयड. It can only be converted from one form into the other. Total energy of the universe remains constant. This is the statement of law of conservation of energy. So write down the statement first, then we will do the examples. Write down the statement of the law of conservation of energy. So it states that total energy of the universe remains constant. Total energy of the universe remains constant. Energy can neither be created. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, full stop. It can only be converted from one form into the other. It can only be converted from one form into the other. Into the other. Okay. So now let's have examples of this law of conservation of energy. First example is that of a simple pendulum. It's a simple pendulum. Okay, have you ever seen a simple pendulum? Yes, students, have you ever seen a simple pendulum? You know, simple pendulum is only a thread. It is only a thread, and when we attach a ball to it, it becomes a simple pendulum. Okay, very simple. Simple pendulum is anything attached to a thread, and then we oscillate. The simple pendulum, we give it a jerk and then we release it, it starts off oscillating, and we note down the time for one oscillation also using a stopwatch. Okay, we note down the time for one oscillation also. See, this is a simple pendulum. We have attached a pendulum bob to a thread. Ek thread ke saath isko humne suspend kar diya, stand ke saath attach kar diya, so this will become a simple pendulum. Okay, this is a simple pendulum. All right. So, isko hum displace karte, it starts oscillating like this. Theek hai? So, is tarah se oscillate karna start kar dete. Right. So, this is a simple pendulum. Right. Now, at every position of this simple pendulum, this pendulum bob will have same energy. Total energy will remain the same. Otherwise, the forms of energy will keep on changing, But if we add the energies, total energy will remain the same at every position of simple pendulum. So let us draw it. इसको डॉटेड ड्रॉ कर लो, ठीक है? So this is a simple pendulum. This is mean position. This is extreme position, जहां से हमने इसको रिलीज किया था. This is also extreme position. ठीक है? If we consider the mean position at the ground level, then when the pendulum goes to the extreme position, it is at maximum height. When the pendulum goes to extreme position, it is at maximum height from the ground level. So it will have which kind of energy? When height is maximum, which energy depends upon height? अभी आपने मुझे फॉर्मूले बताए थे, कौन सी एनर्जी जो हाइट पे डिपेंड करती है? Which energy? Arshita, you tell me.
Ma'am, potential energy.
Potential energy, yes. That is potential energy, MGH. So that means when the pendulum bob is at extreme position, it will have maximum potential energy. What about the kinetic energy? It will stop and then come back. ठीक है, जब ये पेंडुलम ऑसिलेट कर रहा है, ये एक्सट्रीम पोजीशन में जाके स्टॉप हो जाता है. व्हेन इट स्टॉप्स, व्हाट अबाउट काइनेटिक एनर्जी? व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी? यस जतिन, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी?
मैम हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर. मैम जब पोटेंशियल एनर्जी सबसे ज्यादा होगी तब वो जीरो होगी काइनेटिक एनर्जी. एंड मैम जब
हाँ ठीक है, तो मैंने बस ये पूछा है कि काइनेटिक एनर्जी कितनी होगी. व्हेन इट विल स्टॉप, काइनेटिक एनर्जी विल बी मैक्सिमम, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ मैक्सिमम हाइट पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज मैक्सिमम, बिकॉज ऑफ स्टॉपिंग काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज जीरो. ठीक है, सो बी रिलैक्स राइट हियर. काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज जीरो, रीजन इज क्लियर, बिकॉज इट विल स्टॉप एंड देन कम बैक, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ मैक्सिमम हाइट पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज मैक्सिमम. Or if we find the total energy at this position, it will be equal to total potential energy. It will be equal to whole of the potential energy because kinetic energy is zero right now. Now let us talk about the mean position. When the pendulum bob reaches the mean position, it is at the ground level. Height zero ho gayi, so potential energy will become zero because it depends upon height. So at mean position, you will write potential energy is zero. Okay. So where does that kinetic energy go that it had? Where does that potential energy go that it had? That whole of the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. Okay. But still total energy will remain the same. Total energy will still remain the same, whereas the form of energy has changed. Okay. So this is the law of conservation of energy. Suppose at extreme position, kinetic energy was zero, potential energy was 5 joule. Total energy was 5 joule. When the pendulum bob will reach the mean position, then potential energy will be zero, kinetic energy will become 5 joule. Kinetic energy will be maximum. Why kinetic energy will be maximum? Because the pendulum bob will reach the mean position with maximum speed. सबसे ज़्यादा speed pendulum bob की throughout the journey of सिंपल पेंडुलम कहां पे होती है? मीन पोजीशन पे. ठीक है, इन बिटवीन क्या हो रहा होता है? व्हाट हैपेंस इन बिटवीन? हियर पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज मैक्सिमम, हियर काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज मैक्सिमम. इन बिटवीन कन्वर्जन इज टेकिंग प्लेस, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज बीइंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू काइनेटिक एनर्जी इन बिटवीन. और मीन पोजीशन तक आते आते सारी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी काइनेटिक एनर्जी में कन्वर्ट होती है. ठीक है, सो सेम थिंग हैपेंस एट द अदर एक्सट्रीम आल्सो. सो टोटल एनर्जी इज स्टिल द सेम. ठीक है, सपोज कर लो यहाँ पे 5 जाउल थी, टोटल एनर्जी 0 प्लस 5 जाउल हो गई, तो यहाँ पे मीन पोजीशन पे 5 जाउल ही होगी काइनेटिक एनर्जी इफ वी मेजर. सो दैट टोटल एनर्जी विल बी अगेन द सेम
at all the positions, total energy will remain the same. So at extreme position, again, the pendulum bob will stop. Kinetic energy will become zero. Potential energy will become maximum. And total energy will also be maximum.
So this is how it happens. So we see at every point of simple pendulum, every point of journey of simple pendulum, total energy is conserved. Energy is constant. So the law of conservation of energy holds here. Okay, so the law of conservation of energy holds here. Is that right, students? Koi doubt isme? Okay, clear. So how will you write this answer? You will explain just in 3-4 sentences and write the question. Iska question kya banega? Justify the law of conservation of energy. Justify the law of conservation of energy for a simple pendulum. Justify the law of conservation of energy for a simple pendulum. So just in 3-4 sentences, you will explain this, that when we disturb a pendulum, it starts oscillating. Okay, when it goes to extreme position, it stops for a moment. So that's why kinetic energy is zero there. And since it is at maximum height, potential energy is maximum there. Okay, after that, when it returns back to the mean position, the potential energy starts getting converting into kinetic energy. And at the mean position, kinetic energy is maximum because of maximum speed of pendulum bob. And because of ground level, because of zero height, potential energy of simple pendulum becomes zero. So same thing is repeated at the other extreme also. Is that clear now? So this way, total energy is conserved at all the positions of simple pendulum. Mean position also, extreme position also. Is that fine? Is that okay, students? Chaliye, second example. Second example hai humara for a freely falling body. And we will prove it through a derivation. Question likhiye. Justify the law of conservation of energy. This is an example also. Aur hum isko separate question bhi bana sakte hain. Justify the law of conservation of energy. Justify the law of conservation of energy for a freely falling object. For a freely falling object. So let us take the example of a freely falling object. So consider an object of mass m falling through a height h from point A. ठीक है, तो हम एक m mass की object को A point से drop करवा रहे हैं, freely fall करवा रहे हैं. This is the situation. Draw it. Okay, this is the situation. That let an object of mass m fall freely through a height h from a point A. Now, if the law of conservation of energy is justified for this freely falling body, at every point of freely falling object, total energy should remain the same. At every point of this object, total energy should remain the same. So let us prove it. So first point we have taken A, let us see how much total energy is there at A point. Then same energy we will prove at two more other points. At least three points we will take. If at three points total energy is same, that means at every point the energy remains the same. Okay? Okay, it's okay. At point A. फ्री फॉल के टाइम पे यू क्या होता है? जीरो. सो काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज हाफ एम जीरो स्क्वायर.
kinetic energy is zero. When an object falls freely, it doesn't fall with any kinetic energy. So its kinetic energy is zero. And what about potential energy? That is maximum, because it is at maximum height right now. It is mgh. So how much is total energy? It is the sum of kinetic and potential energy. Total energy means mechanical energy. So let us put in the values. Kinetic energy is zero. Potential energy is mgh. So we note that total energy at A point we have got, that is mgh. So we will prove that total energy is mgh at two more points also. दो कोई और पॉइंट्स भी लेंगे वहां पे भी अगर टोटल एनर्जी इतनी ही है तो दैट वुड मीन दैट एनर्जी इज कंजर्व्ड. लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी इज होल्डिंग. तो फर्स्ट पॉइंट पे आपको क्लियर है कैसे निकाली मैंने काइनेटिक और पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. एनी डाउट अप टिल हियर यू कैन आस्क. किसी को इस कैलकुलेशन में या इसमें पॉइंट में कोई डाउट है तो पूछ सकते हो. यस स्टूडेंट्स, if you have doubt you can raise hand. Okay, so now let us take one point B and another point C on the ground. C point humne ground pe le liya, B kahan pe liya, that is our choice. Let us say B point is at a distance x from the top. So what is its height from the ground? Kaun batayega what is the height of B point from the ground? Because it's very important to know height if we want to write potential energy. ठीक है, if we want to write potential energy, Aryan.
मैं x h minus x
h minus x yes. Because total height is h, उसमें से इतना x है. So what is the remaining distance? H minus x. Okay, now one thing more. To find the kinetic energy, we need to have the velocity of that object when it crosses B point and C point. हमें ये तो पता है कि जब वो free fall कर रही है तो u zero है. But we don't know. We know at least this thing कि as it approaches the ground, the speed will go on increasing. Speed increase होती जाएगी, height decrease होती जाएगी. तो potential energy will go on decreasing, kinetic energy will go on increasing. तो हाइट ग्राउंड पे जाके काइनेटिक एनर्जी मैक्सिमम हो जाएगी, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी मिनिमम हो जाएगी. सो दिस इज द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी. वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी स्टार्ट्स गेटिंग कन्वर्टिंग इनटू अनदर फॉर्म. तो बी पॉइंट पे और सी पॉइंट पे कितनी स्पीड से ये क्रॉस कर रही है ऑब्जेक्ट, हमें ये पता होना चाहिए. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट दैट. सो लेट अस अज्यूम दैट स्पीड ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, स्पीड ऑफ दिस स्टोन व्हेन इट क्रॉसेस बी पॉइंट इज वी. So using third equation, first of all, we will find that speed. Okay? So we will continue tomorrow.